Hey guys, what's up? Until now, using Google Colab, we have explored Python basics, statistics for data science concepts, and predictive modeling concepts. Today, I have come up with 10 cool tips and tricks which you can use in Google Colab to enhance the processing speed. Before getting into the video, if you have not subscribed yet, do subscribe my channel, RK Keynotes, to get more updates, and let's dive into the video. The first trick is to enable GPU and TPU. So before that, let's check our RAM and disk. That is, out of 12.72 GB which is allocated to us, I'm using 0.85 GB and the disk space is 107.7 GB, 30.02 GB is used. Alright, until now we have not used any model, or we have not trained any machine learning model and all, so we have not used a GPU and TPU. Basically, GPU is graphics processing unit which you can use for small batches to train, and TPU is a tensor processing unit which is highly optimized and you can process large number of batches, let's say for convolution neural network and all. So how to enable this? Just want to go to runtime and go to change runtime type. Click here and you see this hardware accelerator. As of now, it is none. We have not used any accelerator. Click here and you can select GPU and TPU. There is some limitation, but you can enable all these things and you can use it for free. And if you want use excessive speed, you need to go for premium version. And select GPU, click save, and it is allocating GPU for us. You see that. And once if it is done, it will show you a tick mark over here. Yeah, it is connected with GPU. You see this Python 3 Google Compute engine backed with GPU. Alright, so this is the first trick. So the second trick is data frame filter. We know that data frame, we used to store our CSV data set into a variable called data frame, and then we will explore it, we will display the records and all. So over here, this particular line will allow us to visualize the data bit more. Let's explore this. I'm gonna run this code, and this is a data set, Vega data set, which I'm going to import, which is already available, and that is about US airport details. So this is what we used to get, but over here you can apply these filters and you can visualize the data better. So earlier we have not used these kind of filters, right? So I can filter anything like this, MS or whatever I want, so I'll be getting results according to that. So you can play around all these things. So to unload this, so this is for to get this one, we are using this load underscore ext, and to unload or disable, you can use this unload ext, so that you won't get this kind of option again. Alright, so this is a second trick, and the third trick is to enable active mode. So basically, after 30 minutes, if you have if you are not using, for example, if you are training a model and that model will take 3 to 6 hours to get trained, and if you are not using your PC for 30 minutes, the Google Colab will automatically disconnect this one, right? So what happens is that our training model will get stopped, so again you need to train. So for that, what we can do is just copy this piece of code and keep clicking. And you need to press function F12 or just F12 in your keyboard, and it enables the code. So yeah, go to console and just copy paste this code over here and hit enter, which means that for every 60 seconds, 60,000 in the sense this is 60,000 milliseconds, that is 60 seconds, for every 60 seconds it is going to keep clicking, so that you can train your model so that it won't stop in between after 30 minutes. Fine, copy paste here and hit enter. Okay, so this is the third trick. The fourth trick is to connect your Google Colab things with GitHub. So go to file and you see this save a copy in GitHub. So if you click this one, it will ask you to save the permission and all, and if you see this, see the same got stored in GitHub. This is my GitHub profile, and you can access, even from here you can access Google Colab, open in Google Colab. So again it will open in Google Colab. Fine, so have a copy like this so that whenever you want to share your repository, you can share this link, people can view all these things in an easy way. Fine, So that's the fourth trick. And the fifth trick, I'll come up to this trick later. So I'm gonna send this one down. So you can use this option as well. So we can take this one to the bottom. Okay, because of graphics issue, I'm gonna use that one later. And the sixth trick is about share. You can click here, share, and you can collaborate with people. You can share this Python file, and you can collaborate with people. And so it'll enable a link for you. So it is very easy to share the file. Yeah, so this is what: get link, copy the link, and share with the people whom you want. And the next trick is to comment. You can add some comments for the cell. So this is a cell actually. So click here and add comment. So the comment will appear here. So you have tried something, tried some algorithm, and you have got some error or not. You can note down over here and you can comment. So later you can come across and you can fix it. Okay. So the eighth trick is a shortcut. That is, we frequently use few shortcuts. That is to run all, to run a particular cell, and to move one cell upwards or else move to the next cell. So these are the four things we use frequently. And so how to do this? You just go to so the basic shortcut is Control F9 to run all the cells, or you can go to tools and keyboard shortcuts. You can set, or you can set up your own keyboard shortcuts over here. Add form, set shortcut. So you can set your own shortcuts which wherever you require. All right, so this is one of the trick. And the ninth trick is snippet. What is snippet? Over here you can see this code snippet. Click here. So these are all the pre-built codes, and there are few codes available. You see this, I'm gonna scroll down this hiding coding, and you know, mount GCS, and using TensorFlow. These are all the codes which are, you know, preloaded. You can use this one by simply clicking. For example, we are using to mount our drive, right? Google Drive. So I'm gonna check. Yeah, see this, and I'm gonna click here. And what is this? Open files from Google Drive. Yes, if you click here, you can see the code, and click insert. So this code will get inserted here automatically. Right, so you can run this one, and then can you, so likewise you have got a lot of codes here. You can search in code snippet. So these are all the basic codes which we reuse frequently. So that kind of codes were given in snippets. All right, so the last trick, that is, yeah, over here we have missed this one. So clear output. I want to clear all these outputs, which, yeah, so for that just go to edit and clear all outputs. So which means that this will clear your output. Okay, then I was talking about yeah, this one, file. And you see this, you can download this as ipynb and or .py. So the difference between these two is .py is just a plain Python file where you won't have any kind of output, executed output, where this is a notebook Python file where, see that now just now we have executed this one. If you have not cleared all the output, and then if you download in ipynb file, you can view the code and also the output as well, but not in the .py file. Hope you understood what is this. And the last trick which I'm going to show you is dark mode and Kitty. That is, you just want to go to tools and settings to enable dark mode. Basically the theme will be in light, so you can enable dark. And go to miscellaneous, where you can enable these two checkboxes like Kitty mode, Corgi mode, save. And if you are a dog lover and kitty, so these things, you know, these animations will play around. So as the time increases, you will be getting more kind of stuff like this. So hope you like this video and try all these tricks, and see you in the machine learning tutorial. And also, if you have got any queries, feedback or requirements, do let me know in the comment section, which will motivates me and also which helps me to make a video on the required concept.